Evening everyone, how are we all doing tonight? Hope we're well and had a good day. Welcome along 1174 and Kirk. So we're having a bit of a change tonight. I said we'd have a look at something different. This could go right, this could go wrong. I've got a few of the controls sorted on here. So we're having a look at cattle and crops tonight. We'll get the microphone activated. Screen up and bring you two back in. So we're going to go right in from the beginning on the start screen. I've got no mods installed on here whatsoever. There are mods out there for this. This is completely basic. Going in with our count up here. Going in on the basic map, not the tech demo map. Even without, how are we doing? We get a fun farming fact here that cows can't fly without the help of a tornado. Good point, anyone who saw the film Twister will know that's true. Tells us how many animals are on the map. With his sole person there, 22 missions, 49 fields. 1200 hectares. So I've not done anything on here yet. I did have a look on another save game the other night on a different profile. Just gotta let it load in. So remember, this is early access still. We just spawn randomly on here. Do you have a dynamic sky on here, as you can see? You'll have to let me know what it looks like and what the game volume is like once we get going, because I need to play with the sound still on here. So I've got it set up for wheel and mouse and some functions on the joystick. And there are a few sort of weird things going on here, but as I say, it's early access game still. It's not going to be perfect. You'll see when if a car approaches, there's something very weird goes on with them. It's still fairly basic. What we need to do before we do anything else is accept a mission. So, go left control and use the mouse. Come up to this welcome to Abergtel, if that's how you pronounce it. There's the weirdness, the car starts to float as it loses the wheels as it goes away from you. So, we've got two missions here. Or quests, as they call them. We've got accept the farm, including a small starting fleet of bulls and some fields you have to take care of. We have a class Arion 530, MB track 1400, cockling rebel classic 300 cultivator, the class front loader, a grab, a vertimix, a plow. And that's basically the rewards we start with. Plus fields 14, 16, 15, 13, 48, 36, 28, and 3. So we can accept that one. Or we can accept bring in the hay. Welcome along, GD and Jim Bob. So if we accept that one, we have those at our disposal. So we've got story mode. We've got tutorials, generic, and test. We're going to leave it how it is. We're going to accept this one to start with, so we get the farm. Oh, you'll like this, GD. It's just creating our content. Right. So you'll see in the top left corner, it's now saying we've got to find the MB track. Easiest way to find the MB track is tab to it. That would be the class. That'll be the MB track. So we found that quick enough. So we can go inside outside with them. So we've got the MB track now, which we really did find. I think we need to just jump out of that and back in again, because that's not sense that we found it. For some reason. don't know what the game sounds are like. So I would imagine we're probably going the wrong direction at the minute, looking at the arrows down the bottom of the screen. So we'll just do a quick U-turn. Hey Nathan, how are we doing? I don't think the MB track was quite where it was supposed to be somehow. Just follow the blue line. Just looks like the MB track was supposed to be there when we found it. Bit of animation on the driver's arm movements down there. I don't know what the vehicle sounds are like. Good, thanks Nathan, how are you doing? Go inside. Just follow the sat nav to the vehicle shop. Up the feeder wagon. So we'll go outside again for that bit. Still getting used to all the controls on there. Yeah, they got good sounds with that one. Thought you'd pick up on the tire noise, GD. Nicely detailed vehicles as well. Self-cancelling indicators fitted to them as well. Animated gear sticks, so it's got a few nice bits. Just see if we stop, it goes through the gears. Some sort of gear stick movement anyway, not quite where it should be, but it moves, works. We can try taking on a certain mission again, but it glitched the other night and wouldn't work, but we'll try it again and see what happens. We can always end up, it's not the end of the world. Certainly is, Jim Bob. Right, so detach the Vertimix. Well, I'm not going to detach that there. I learned that the other night. Do not detach where it tells you to. Yet there are mods available for this, Jim Bob. Not too many. If you leave the feeder wagon there, it's right in the way. So have a look around the yard while we're up here. You see, I was teasing GD with this one I bought at the weekend about MB tracks. Right, so if we want to stop this, this is where it's a bit different to Farm Sim. Hop back inside, hold down left control, and we've got lots of interactive functions coming up. You have to turn it off with the key, got change driving orientation. So we can turn ourselves around. True MB track fashion. Have four-wheel drive, parking brake. Want a bit of fresh air? Well, we just open the front window. Front wiper. We have a rear wiper. We can open and close the windows. Back window open and closes as well. Want the roof hatch open? Well, that opens as well with the IC. There's lots of IC in here. And of course, the door opens with IC. And you can adjust the mirrors. I don't know, GD, to be honest. So if you want to just hop out, it's E. Don't know if the doors can open and close from the outside, but we're about to find out. The answer is yes. They are working on manual attaching for this as well. So have a look around. Anyone want the cat? Has Fudge moved into here, Dal?
Yeah, it looks that way.
Pressure wash, I'm sure I saw a dog walking about over here somewhere as well. I did. So we have ourselves our little doggy here. Silage clamps over there. Looks like a silo in here. There is a glitch in this shed. So we've got our four furrow player there. We've got our cultivate here, but there's a slight issue with it where they've positioned it when it spawns. Anyone spot the problem with that? I did tell you two about this last night in here. There is a cultivation contract, but we need to bash the cultivator away from the wall with the tractor first to do it. We got a bit more around the back here. Got our loader and the bucket.
You better get that through the wall. You're fine.
No, collision on the wall. Yeah. Tried it. We have our cattle in there. Does it not, Nathan? So there are cattle on there now. They actually move as well. And they're not levitating above the ground.
Ooh.
They do slide sideways and do silly things, but they do move. They do sort of slide. They've got a rather weird hairdo on their head. As I say, it's still early access game and in work in progress. And the dog sort of keeps moving around. So we now need to look at a contract or mission or whatever they want to refer to him as. So up the top there we've got it smells but we need it and bring in the hay. Which one do we want to have a look at?
Hay.
Hay? Okay. Haven't looked at that one yet. Hey Stephen, how are we doing? Haven't got that far yet, Nathan. So let's have a look at the hay one then. So 30 to 60 minutes, we have a mower. The grass has to be mowed, tedded multiple times and dried down. So GD wants smells. Now there's a surprise. Mainly because that's the one which glitched out probably knowing you, GD. So we have this slurry one in here. As well. That's the one which wouldn't work last night. Oh, we're still looking, Steve, and haven't played it very long yet. Can't do the same thing all the time, Nathan. So we'll accept the hay one. Okay, so we must be at the shop. So class is the same, that has IC as well. So we want to get the tractor started, we need to get the key. This one may glitch out as well, I don't know. So we need to drive to field 47. I have no clue where field 47 is. We'll follow the sat nav again. This would be field 47 then. Wheel and joystick and mouse. It's a mixture at the moment. Just gotta remember which control does what on there at the moment. Obviously not in the field there. Or maybe we are, we're just going too quick. Hey Brendan, how are we doing? Graphics are, well, it's not farm sim, put it that way, with the graphics. That's early access still, so you're not expecting the same level. And Dal, you've looked at this before, what does it compare like to when you looked at it last time?
That's a lot better.
Yeah.
When you break a Scott, you need to have two tracks, no animals and nothing. So they are doing well with it.
Yeah.
They're taking the time with some.
I mean, there's mods on Forbidden Mods for this. Yeah. There's mods on Mod Hoster for this. It's only released as an early access game, Jim Bob. It's not finished, but it's a long way. Oh, good, thanks, Brendan. Exactly, Nathan. Difference is, this has still got features on here that Farm Sim hasn't got.
Yeah, I see.
I see, yeah. And dynamic soil.
Also, have you noticed, when you're in the MB track, if you're sitting there and let it run, it's got like a tiny little rattle to it.
Yeah.
Really quite nice little things on there.
Exactly, GD. I think some people may have been unnecessarily hard on this game. Cut a bit more and we'll have a look at what the grass texture is actually like as it lies there. Okay, catch you later, Brendan. Thanks for stopping by. To be honest, Paul, waggle along. Not really played it that long to form an opinion yet. It's early access, there are some issues with it. You just take what it is and hope it improves with time. Probably a lot of it, GD. I can't tell you what the FPS is because this isn't through Steam, so I haven't got on screen. Keep meaning to have a look at how to get that up on the download game. It's certainly running okay, but I'd have been worried if it wasn't on my PC.
I was on it the other day, I think I was getting 40 FPS.
Right.
Then I didn't upload it and then
I watched a couple of YouTube videos on this. Got the game direct from Catlin Crops. Straight off their website. Had tried to get a free key for it from elsewhere but didn't get one. I haven't actually looked, JD. Who knows, Jim Bob? As I say, it's early access. Game isn't finished, but I would imagine there's already modded vehicles for it, it's a possibility.
That massive Supernova looks really nice.
Yeah.
Got 39
as well. Yeah, I mean, it's very blocky how you cut the grass here. But further refinement may sort that. Let's just stop that there a second. Have a look at some grass and see what it looks like. So it's grass textures don't look too bad, especially lying in the swaths there. I've seen worse grass textures. I've got it set on run everywhere at the moment. Cut grass texture definitely looks better, Paul, as it lies in the swaths. I've done no test streams with this either, so I haven't seen what it looks like on the other end of the stream.
It's looking alright.
Yeah?
Yep.
Not too loud with the game sounds.
I don't know if I knew it. Cross GD levels.
Soon let you know if you go over the speed you're supposed to be doing.
No, game sounds are good.
Sorry?
Game sounds are good.
Good. Just slow that time down a bit. Okay, catch you later, GD. You need to be about 15k forward speed. Thanks, JD. That's unlike me not to have done a test stream with it beforehand, but I was late home tonight. We got home at 6 o'clock. I have to have a look and see if I can get the FPS up somehow. Must be a way of doing it. There's two maps, it looks like, Paul. There are some mods out there, but I've not tried any yet. Some Massey Ferguson tractors, drill, cultivator, welder, quadrant style baler, 60-60. Do get a bit of a pause when the game saves at the moment. Interesting to see how many times we have to ted this hay. I did say I'd be tedded multiple times, I think, in the list there. Try something new if it appeals to me, Paul. Can't stick to the same thing all the time on the channel. Damn, I've been hanging around GD too much. These little snakes down the field. Doesn't always slow down when you want it to. Hi Sam, how are you doing? Racking up experience points anyway, which is a good thing. So once you got so far between it comes up with you can skip doing it. Yeah, mix for guys. Did say I might do something different tonight. If I could get it sorted. For features, FS19 has definitely got the edge over this game at the moment. You're talking about a game which has been around for 10 years, Robert. This one hasn't. It's still in development. That would be an interesting one. Saw the physics off air going into the game. Yeah, it's a lot better than I thought it was going to look. I watched a few YouTube videos on this before I bought it, just to see if it's going to be worth it, and I thought I'd have a go at it. It's a lot better than I thought. There's another imminent update due on this one, that I've been reading. If you look at the cut grass texture, it doesn't look too dissimilar to what some of Frontier Design's cut grass textures look like from a distance. Yeah, PC, Robert. The cows don't float on here, so I guess that's an improvement, but they do slide sideways as if they've been pushed along on a sheet of ice. Who knows, Robert? There's only one group of people who could answer that, and that'd be the developers as to whether they intend to put it that way. Certainly at the moment it'd be a long way off going to console. We're actually going to finish cutting all the grass before we take the vehicle back to the shop. Chat has a habit of doing that at the time, Jim Bob. Chat freezing comment. Yeah, chat does freeze sometimes, Jimbo. Sometimes freezes this end and needs refreshing. That's all animated blades and everything on the mower. Ah, I see, Jim Bob. Your chat definitely did freeze then. It's too bad the detail in the implements, really. You're not going to try and break that PCI 1174 if you have a rage moment. I remember what you said last time. So the tether seems to have vibrated its way round a bit. So we've got to go back to Field 47 now. Something this game will not let you do. You can't go owling in here, so you can't turn any further around than there in the seat. Each way. Let's see what we have to do with the tedding then. So there's a few sort of bits and pieces missing from machines. The PGO shaft is missing off there, but this one has got hoses on it. Right, so we now need to spread the hay. Right, I can hide all that lot so we get a better view of what's going on. It does sound a bit more like a tedder. Blimey, so you've actually got to check it to see if that's drawing enough. So it's not like farm sim where you've got to just cut it instantly. Ted it to get it to hay, we've got to actually keep doing it. Let's get rid of that. So you've got to check regularly using the Alt key while looking at different parts of the field. Okay. As long as the game doesn't crash, we'll be fine. Does seem like it, Jim Bob. Bit hard to see where you've been at the minute. Guessing by how it behaves in the tether, some bits of the field are already drier than others. You notice the bits what are giving the tedding texture seem to be in the sun. Places. Seem to be, but now they're all over the place, so it's just be a thing with the tedder at the moment. Back up, see what's going on. It's supposed to be the ultimate realistic game, really, by doing that. I think that's exactly what Seasons intends to bring to Farm Sim this time, from what I saw of it. But hay is going to be more like this to do. Certainly racking up the XP points. The shop on the map here, Paul. Just follow the line on the sat nav to find them. Don't know, Jim Bob, it might do. Looks like if you go too quick, the tether stops working. So watch that one. for when Caesar's come to farm sim. If I've got this, she'll be doing the same way, I think. Sure, that's what one of the photos came up with on screenshots a few weeks back. So if we then have to take on a bailing contract for this. Might be we have to take on that slurry one in the meantime while this dries. Problem is it's evening time on the map now because I didn't slow the time down soon enough. At least you can sort of see what the tether's doing. Got a better texture to it in that respect. Yeah, let's hope that doesn't happen, Jim Bob, because that was a bit quick. Need to keep it below 15k. That looks of it. The minute you go above that, it stops tedding. Alright, so I'm guessing we now have to just wait for it to dry a bit. So see, this has got all the IC on it as well. Just have a look at the grass then. That's interesting. Needs a bit of dry on that. Didn't quite realise that was like that when you went to check the moisture of the grass. So definitely need some sunshine on that. Right, so let's see if we can take on any more contract missions, whatever you want to call them. Why not that one equals two? Right, so we're going to have a look at that one while the grass dries. Presume we can take them both at once. This is the one which glitched last night and I couldn't do it. The Wopster certainly did not do that, Jim Bob. It's a lot more precise. Alright, so we need to go across to our 530. Get that started up. Turn lights on. Not bad, Nathan. How's it split now? It's a sort of like between console and PC. What is the actual console figure at now? See if this works tonight. It certainly didn't last night. Ooh, not bad. See if this is going to behave itself. So we've got hoses there. All connect up. Certainly not the hoses to the tractor. See if this works. Fingers crossed. I don't have much confidence, unfortunately. So let's see if we can unfold this tonight. This is where it all went wrong last night, wouldn't unfold. Oh, it's behaving tonight. We have progress. Gotta make sure we got four-wheel drive in. And there's something which Farm Sim is missing. We have wheel marks in the field. So let's hop in the tractor for a second. So four-wheel drive is in. You can see puddles on the field behind us. Not quite sure what speed this is supposed to be going at, but it's not telling us to slow down. We get proper wheel marks in the field with this anyway. I'm presuming one tank of four is all we need on here. Look how those puddles have appeared on the field. It's not just changing the field's colour, it's actually giving it a different sort of look to it with the puddles and dark and light patches. Probably glitched out last night because that's something I was doing to it. There's something to do with the controller, the steering wheel. Not liking it. If they say update the game, things will keep improving on here. Yeah, that isn't the easiest to see where you've been, but I can roughly see a dark sort of texture there. Quite doesn't help that I'm zoomed out fairly. There is a darker texture to it. But it's getting dark on here as well, which ain't helping. It's quite a big field, this one, really. There is a bit of a manual gearbox option on here. You know, I can, stuck in auto at the minute, I can knock it down a gear. It's set up to do that. Have a look and see how to turn the auto gears off. I've got it set up on the shifter to manually change up and down the gears. Machines are nicely detailed on there. Helps I don't turn the steering wheel when I zoom in on it. See if we can skip to the morning somehow on here. Looks like we might run out of slurry at the moment. Okay, Jim Bob, thanks for stopping by. Try not to make it sound like you're strangling too many cats or doing anything with that guitar. Yeah, that is certainly true, 1174. It's not as bad as some people have made it out to be. Or doesn't seem to be, that's for certain. The wrong button. Actually got the volume turned up louder for in vehicle and out of vehicle. Yeah, it's nearly 6 PM on the game, Paul. See if we can finish this mission and then maybe sleep on here. Not sure if it's going to make us fill up and do some more of the field or whether that's actually sound enough at the moment. Sound complete up there. Okay, so we haven't finished yet. We need to fill up again. Luckily, slurry isn't too expensive to buy. Finish the field off. Machine does get dirty. In fact, the dirt looks quite good how it's on there. No, probably at 1174, if it doesn't appeal at the minute, it isn't exactly the cheapest game to get into. Welcome along, Rabbit Man. How are we doing? Got your favourite brand of tractor I'm driving at the moment? Start over the far side and work back to where we ran out. Too much left on there. Shouldn't take too long to do this last little bit of field, hopefully. At least it's not getting dark like someone's turning a light switch down every once in a while on here. And it's gradual. The sat nav in the bottom corner is quite a handy feature until you get used to the map. All good still, Nathan? How you doing now? More to the point, have you exploded those John Deeres yet? Very true, 1174. The two together could be an interesting combination. Ooh, look forward to seeing what you do with them, Nath. Hopefully you have more luck with them than I did. Try to do it. And I spend quite a bit of time around GD, so that probably explains why I can break things so easily in GE. As you turn on those two taps in the middle on the back, they're turned down. Have a look when we get up the other end. I knew you were still lurking, GD. That's just however I find the best way possible to de-lurk you. And I manage it every time. If I turn this off at the end here, those two taps move. We'll keep speeding up by itself doing this down the hill. Alright, so we're back to where we ran out last time. What's he think to that then, Rabbit Man? I don't think that's a bad game. Another one that I think might have been unfairly slighted by some people. Mostly because it's not Farm Sim and it's not fair to compare it to Farm Sim. If you combined the good features of all three games, you would have one heck of a game to play. I mean, like the FPS is getting a bit twitchy at the moment on here. And the front number plate, Nathan, please. Okay, we've done that one. So we've still got the hay one ongoing. go and try tedding that again, seeing what it does. It takes a little bit more than a couple of goos, depends how long you play it for. It does take a while to get into that game. Trying to remember the way back to the farm though. Because I'm not following anything, it won't show the directions. I think from memory we can sleep up here if we need to. Just get rid of these notifications. We do have our house over here. I think there was a way of sleeping in this somehow. See that we fast forward the time. And how much we can fast forward it by in one go. Quite an amount by the looks of it. Yeah, if it's quite a while ago, Rabbit Man, it's worth him having another go at it. Nice night sky on, eh? In fact, it's quite a decent night sky on here. Why are vehicles auto start? Right, let's have a look at our hay. So we'd better move that again. If we want to do this properly, I suppose we can open the door and get in that way. See what we're doing a bit better now as daylight. No front plate whatsoever, Nathan. Nice. Try getting back to how they'd be in this country, and we don't have front number plates. What I might do is just do one stream a week on cattle and crops the next couple of weeks. See how we go. Something different. So no quick maturing hay on here. Sort of starts to change colour as it dries out. Looks to me like there's different colours on this field now. It's hard to see where you've been on here. Now we're getting lots and lots of wheel marks. Outside once we're done the middle. Make sure we've got everything. So it looks to me like there's some dry bits now and some greener bits on here. Looks to me like this isn't the sort of game where you think, oh no, I'm out of hay, I must do some and get it done within the next 5 minutes. Yeah, it certainly seems to, Rabbit Man. Have another look at the hay once we've done it all and see how we're doing. Have a walk across the field and check the moisture. Too quick again. Looks a lot more realistic grass stroke hay texture. Now we go across the field and check it all again. All right, let's have a look. Still a bit on the damp side. So let's put this back up. So we've got to draw it down to 50%, so we need it to probably just go a little bit quicker on the time. So we've got a bit of cultivating to do there. So I have to accept that while it is drying on here. So we've got to do something a bit unrealistic here, for those that can remember when we looked in the barn. The cultivator is in a bit of a awkward position to deal with. kind of anything. Hopefully you got them to work. So we've got to move that cultivator so we can pick it up. Because there's collision on the wall. So we've got to try and push it out of the shed. Or into, at least into a better position for us to be able to hook onto. When the tractor decides it wants to move. It's one of the minor little issues I've found so far with the game. It's trying to get that cultivator where you can actually pick it up. Which we should be able to get there, hopefully. Not a very big field this one. I did do this one last night. This is Catlin Crops, Austin. Just leave us wheel marks there, we've got to try and fill in. Keeping you awake, Milton? Keeping you awake there?
Yeah.
Sure, I can hear yawning.
Alright.
Could be offended at that, you know?
Yes, alright.
Stops doing this after the first couple of tracks, we then have to match it up. You get proper movement in there. If I was leaving that deep wheel mark in real life, I'd want to put dual wheels on it. Don't know if you use the MB track yet for a contract. There is one coming up that involves it though. We need to get this one done first. Get this done, then we'll have to check the grass again. What are your thoughts so far, GD? I know you're sort of half torn with looking at it, mainly due to the MB track. Is it a bit too realistic for you? It's exploded, Nathan. That's good then. Yeah, I thought that might be a little bit on the realistic side for you, GD. When it comes down to do the hay like that, etc., it's not something you sort of get through quickly. Mustn't be lured by nice sounding MB tracks with interesting features. Thanks, Nathan. Yep, this has all got the new updates in, Nathaniel. Latest version. Looks to me like we finished that one. Oh, that just changed colour. I did, Nathan. Right, let's detach this somewhere out of the way. Ah, I see. He told you I could break things in GE. Try to work out how you sleep in here. Right. See, if we bring up F2, which is a good feature, you can actually see your key bindings on the screen. I know there is, Nathaniel. Ah, that would explain it then. Told you, I can break things in GE. I don't know about fixing them, I can break them. That's one we want. It's a couple of hours since we were last down here. So we're down at sort of 69.70. That's where we're going to leave it on here for tonight, though. A couple of bits I need to sort out, particularly a video for tomorrow, as it isn't uploaded yet. So I'd like them. So I'll pop a link in the chat for today's video. Let me know either in comments on this one that goes up or Discord what you think of it, whether we do more. I'll just mute you guys for a couple of seconds up there.
Sound muted. Microphone muted.
But that's where we're going to leave it for today. So for now, I will say thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this stream, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye for now.